Hey YouTubers, Iggy here, and I'm back to show you guys what I actually use for those pan fishing lures. I know a few of you guys have asked me for it, and here it is. So, let's get started by saying thank you to my subscribers, thank you for those of you guys who liked my videos, and thank you for you who shared my videos. So thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And here we go. Well, my first video, I posted a pan fishing lure making video. So this is what I actually had made that time, is I made a bunch of these lures, pan fishing lures. I don't know if you guys can see those, but yeah, you know, made a bunch of these guys, you know. And really all it is some hooks, which, oh, I forgot to grab those, but I got some here. I always keep hooks. But the hooks that I use, it's really your preference on the hooks that you want to use for whenever you guys want to go pan fishing. But I usually use like Eagle Claw hooks, and I'll use the Octopus Long Shank size number fours. So that's what I use to make these guys here. So, you know, if you watch that first video, this is the size that I actually used. And you can get these at like Walmart or, you know, Bass Pro, Cabela's, Big Five, you know, any of your sports places that has any fishing tackle, I'm sure they have Eagle Claw stuff. So once you've gotten to pick the hooks that you want, you know, because, you know, you can use whatever you want, you know. If you don't like Eagle Claws and say you like Gamagatsus, then get some Gamagatsus, you know. These are not that size, but I like Gamagatsus also, you know. They just didn't have any of those the day that I went, you know. A lot of people like those as well as I do, so. Anyways, so, hooks. You can use those, or you can even use these, the regular worm hooks, bait holder hooks. They're also Eagle Claws, and I'm sure you guys, if you guys been fishing, you guys know what kind of hooks these are already. I don't need to explain to you guys, because you guys are probably better than I am. So whatever, you know, it is what it is. But that's what that is there. I'll give you a show on that. And like I said, it's basically your choice. Whatever you want to use, that's fine. If you find a bigger hook and you want to do the same thing, you want to mimic it, fine. Try to do it with the bigger hook. Now, the next thing. Okay, we'll try to make one of these as we go. Let's see. I'll just open one of these up. Now, these hooks are pretty sharp, so I like that they put them in this little like organizer clip deal thing here. I love that. So you don't, you know, open the bag and it goes everywhere when you're out fishing. You know, that's pretty neat. So we'll just set those aside. So you got your hooks. So the next thing would be your clay. This is just regular baking clay. This is a Kato poly clay, and I got this at Hobby Lobby. And the rest, really all the stuff that I got to use for all these lures, you can pretty much buy at like Hobby Lobby or Michael's, any of those hobby places. Now this is a clay that you can bake and it hardens up, so you can't just use any ordinary clay. Like, you know, this is ordinary clay and it doesn't work at all because it doesn't harden up. It stays soft all the time. So you don't want to use that. You want to go to the hobby store and ask them for any kind of oven baked clay that hardens up after, you know, you're finished molding it or doing what you're doing. And there's many, many different colors that you can buy. You don't have to buy just these colors. I mean, look at this one. This is from Hobby Lobby and it's got the price tag on it and everything. So you get the idea. The clay, and the clay, you pretty much, you know, it'll give you the directions and tell you what temperature it needs to be baked at, for how long. So check that out. Make sure that you always follow the directions on that too. So just, you know, just to be safe, you know, don't try to say, oh yeah, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna blast the heat. Let's get this done quicker. Don't do that. Don't do that. Big mistake. So basically, like I said, whoops, I dropped that one. But like I said, you can buy many colors. This one's white, this one's pink, the one I just dropped is orange, and it's probably gonna be all dirty now, but I'll grab it. And as you see right here, it is orange. So these are basically the clays that I use to make those pan fishing lures. There could be different brands, like this one is a Van Aken brand, and this one's a different brand. The sticker's covering up. Let's see what it is. Sculpey, something like that. I don't know. But yeah, you can see it right there. You've seen how much they are. Of course, that's how much they cost where I live. I don't know wherever how much they cost where you live, but could be a difference. Also, I did, you know, start shaping the clay onto there, so I'll kind of show you what else I use for that. An X-Acto knife, and I think everybody pretty much knows what an X-Acto knife is. These are very, very sharp, very, very pointy, so be careful when you use one of these. You know, they got this little protective cap, so when you're not using it, put it away, you know, just put it away. Put it away. You know, I've already had many moments where this was rolled off and fell on my lap, so I've had my share of pokies. Anyway, so here we go. Get the X-Acto knife, and if your blade is dull, change it. They have replacement blades, and you can also get those at Hobby Lobby. And I'm not sponsoring Hobby Lobby in any way or sponsoring any of this stuff, by the way. I don't do that. This is just the stuff that I use, and I just want to clear that up right now. So whatever it is that you guys decide that you guys want to use, or if you think that you can find something better for you or whatever, then go for it. You know, just you know, I make them, you know, I had the idea because somebody else made them before, you know, so I figured, you know what, I'm just gonna do it the same way, just a little bit different. I'll start to paint mines, get them a little bit more, a little bit details in there, throw some of that glow in the dark paint, and you got yourself some pretty cool pan fishing lures, and they work. But yeah, so this is some wire. You could also get it at Hobby Lobby. It's like the little thin baling wire, and do they have it there where you know they have all the wire beads and all that stuff, so you can pick this up at Hobby Lobby as well. It doesn't cost that much, it's probably a couple bucks, and you know, but it's just some thin wire. And also we got, let's see, what else do we have? The paintbrushes. Okay, your paintbrushes. You want to buy some cheap paintbrushes for when you're doing the epoxy. And the epoxy, it hardens up like within 5 minutes. This is 5 minute epoxy, and again, you don't have to buy this brand. This brand is BSI, Bob Smith Industries. It's worked pretty well for me. You know, I don't know, you can use whatever it is that you want. They also sell this at Hobby Lobby. It's about 10 bucks for the kit, maybe 11 bucks, you know, somewhere around there. It's inexpensive, and with the amount that you can mix with this, you can make a lot of stuff, you can create a lot of stuff. Just use your imagination, like I said, you know, before. You can make a lot of stuff. Whatever you want to make, you can make it. Just do it, you know. Just never let somebody tell you, oh, that's too hard. Yeah, right, you can do it. You know, a woman can do this stuff, a man can do stuff, you know, whatever. Everybody's doing things. It's just, oh, well, you know, it looks hard. Sometimes it looks hard, but, you know, if you really, you know, just put a few minutes into it, do it. So, the paints and the paintbrushes, like I was telling you, buy yourself some cheap paintbrushes, because these things are going to harden up with that epoxy once you seal them up. they're never gonna be any good anymore. So these ones are good to throw away. Then you also wanna get you some better paint brushes, some with different size tips. And I probably only paid like maybe $6 for a set of these. I already missing a few of these because I probably, you know, messed up, didn't have any more. So I had to use them for some epoxy, and I'm gonna be the first one to say that I did do that. And that's why I don't have the complete set, because I was impatient and I wanted to get something done, and I used some of the good ones and ruined them. But nonetheless, I still have some more and we're good. So make sure you get you a set that has, you know, lots of different size tips, like this one right here. I don't know if you can see that, but that's like really, really thin. And this one's real thick, and that one is like a chisel point, you know. But you want to get some for the fine details, like to do make little dots and stuff like that, like, you know, on stuff like that, you know. It's so small, so you're gonna be wanting to get good paintbrushes. Or you could even use like a toothpick or a drill bit, you know, just the flat end of a drill bit. Just dunk it in the paint and, you know, dab it on a little index card. I mean, that's all. I got index cards where you could just dab it on an index card. It ain't no big deal. But on your paints, on the paints, I also buy paints from Hobby Lobby, and then sometimes I'll buy like paints from Walmart. Like these ones here are the Cretex or Createx, I don't know how many, whatever, but you see here, those are for airbrushing. And so, you know, $5, you know. And these here are these Apple Barrel paints, and you know, you can pick these up at Walmart. Sometimes they're on sale for 50 cents, sometimes they're a dollar or whatever. But for stuff like this, you know, you're gonna seal it up with some 5-minute epoxy, you know that it's gonna work. I mean, for whatever you want it to look like, they're gonna work. But you can pretty much buy whatever kind of paints. Like here I have a green one, and this type, I like buying the pearlized ones because they have the neatest effect, and they look so neat. They're more reflective, and I think that you want more reflective things in you know, as a lure anyways, because I don't just make pan fishing lures, you know. I do make other lures other than these, and hopefully I can make a lure fishing video for you guys making those, and I'll just show you like something really quick here in a second. But yeah, so we went over the clay. Now the paints, you know, the painting, it's really use your imagination. Do whatever you want, whatever you think is appetizing to the fish, go with it. If you think it looks delicious to you to eat, I'm thinking a fish is gonna want to eat it too. So, you know, that looks good. And to me, they look like candies. So, delish. I love candy. So, yeah. So on the glow in the dark paint, I also bought this at Hobby Lobby, and it was only like maybe about $7 or $8. Again, all this stuff it's fairly cheap, and for the amount of lures that you're gonna get out of using all this, it's fairly cheap. I mean, yeah, you're gonna put some work into it, but I mean, if you're a person that likes to do this kind of stuff as a hobby or whatever, or on your spare time when you get home from work, or on your off seasons of fishing, you want to, you know, restock your boxes of lures. Like I needed some ice fishing lures and some pan fishing lures, which here they are, you know. I made those because a while back I lost all my tackle. I went fishing at Bear Creek and I was pretty dumb. I left my bag there, took everything else, but I left my bag of tackle there, gone. So it happens, you know, it happens. But I gotta do what I gotta do, and if this is the best way to do it, then try it. And it's worked out. So moving on with that, so you got glow in the dark paint, and then we have just some regular crazy glue. I use crazy glue sometimes because it won't, sometimes the clay won't stick. And I didn't have any problems with it the last time, so you probably didn't see me use it, but it doesn't stick sometimes to the hook. So what I do is I'll get a little dab of this, and this is just Gorilla Glue. It's just super, super glue, and you can get this either at Walmart, Home Depot, or, you know, just about any place. They sell crazy glue. It's just crazy glue. So, but the cool thing about this one that I liked was that you can use it two ways. You could either use it as a pen and just, you know, put a dab of glue of wherever you want it, or, you know, you screw that top lid back on and you unscrew the whole thing and there's a brush. And I love that. I love that about this glue. I mean, that's awesome. I mean, I used to use actual crazy glue, but this, it works the same. I mean, crazy glue is crazy glue, that's what I think. But this one's turned out to work the best for me because of the way that you can applicate it on your, on the stuff you're working. So I like that a lot. And again, that one probably cost probably about maybe $5 or $6, you know. And like I said, you can get it at Home Depot, Walmart, or anywhere that sells super glue or anything like that. We went over the clay, all that. Like I said, yeah, that's basically all. Oh, I haven't forgot this stuff. So yeah, somebody asked me about this. What was the powder that you put into the epoxy resin? So this is powder that you can add to airbrush paints. And I used to race RC cars and I used to paint my cars with this, and I used to mix it in with some of my paints. Now, these paints are actually different brand. They're called Fast Colors, and they're for like Lexan RC car bodies and so forth, and that's what it works best for. But if you want to make just a regular paint or a pearlized paint to have that flake in it, you add this stuff. Now, I use it not just for the paints, but I use it to sprinkle a little tiny bit into the epoxy resin. And what that does is, it's really hard to tell on these little guys the little bit of flake that it puts into a lure, but let me just show you. I believe I have some lures here that I have made that have it. And I'll show you this guy. And this guy was just botched up, but yeah. But all I needed was a pink lure and it worked, you know. But I made this little crankbait there. You know, but I don't know if you can see that. Let me see if we can get further back. But I don't know if you could see the flakes inside of the fish there. But all that glitter really makes them shine, you know. So this one's kind of goofy looking because, I mean, I didn't have any eyes or anything like that. But again, like I said, I've been on it. I've been making different ones of these. And in the future, I'll show you how to make some of these guys, you know. But for now, you get the gist. You've seen where I gotten all my materials from. Like I said, majority of the time, this glitter stuff, this stuff here is a little bit hard to find. I found that you can probably find this. You can't just go to a Hobby Lobby or a Michaels and find this. I'm sure you can probably find some glitter that is extra fine at the hobby stores, but it's not as fine as this one. Like I said, you can run this through an airbrush. You can mix this with some paints and you can run it through an airbrush, and I've used it before, and it's awesome. And so this ended up, it doesn't have anything printed, but I mean, it's really, 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 really fine. I mean, this stuff, it's, I mean, don't spill this stuff. Don't. I mean, just use a, you know, some ice cream sticks. You're going to want to use some ice cream sticks, and everybody knows what an ice cream stick, and if you ain't got no ice creams, go buy a box of ice creams and start eating, and then you'll have some popsicle sticks, you know, or some popsicles at that, you know. But I'm sure you can find those at Hobby Lobby. This stuff, like I said, it is a little bit hard to find. I didn't even actually say, but I believe I bought this at a Hobbytown USA, and I'm sure that if you can't or if you don't have a Hobbytown USA near you, you could probably look it up online. I'm sure you could probably order it online. But it is airbrush, it is the airbrush type glitter, that's the word I'm looking for, glitter, that you can add to fast coat paints and be able to paint Lexan bodies with this. But then again, you know, I'm not using it for that. I'm using it for the finish on the epoxy. So don't tell them that, because they're not going to know what you're talking about. Just tell them you want glitter to add to airbrush paints, and if they have it there, you'll see that it's probably going to be in a little vial like this, because it doesn't take much to add to your paints. So read the directions, follow the directions if you're going to mix it with your paints. So guys, I got all this stuff out. Let's try to make one really quick. This is how I basically, you know, I hope you all can see this, but I'll just go over it real quick. I'm going to make the pink one's already open, so we'll just go ahead and slice just a little bit, like you're slicing some cheese, you know? Like you're going to slice a little bit of cheese off of that. Yeah, it ain't that big. So you get that, and what I usually do is, you know, if you don't have a smooth, flat surface to work on, I have a little index card, you know, and clay doesn't really stick to these little index cards, so you can use whatever, but a lot of people say, oh, I'll use a piece of newspaper. Don't use a piece of newspaper, because all that ink from the paper is going to stick to your clay, and then the color is going to be gone. I mean, completely gone. And again, you want to keep your hands clean before you do this, because all the dirt from your fingers will mold in with the clay, and then you're gonna have this unpinkish color or whatever that you're not gonna like. So I'm just gonna make one of the quickest ones that I make that are really popular, and it's this guy that I made in the video, but I'll make it in pink because I pulled out the pink clay. So, and this one's really easy to make. So you just get your hook there, And you get that piece of clay, and I was just rolling it up to where you can get a nice little wormy thingy like this, you know. And you just roll it across something or surface like that until you get a good size little, you know, 1-2 inch piece or whatever, you know. And what you want to do is you get it, hold it, and just somehow just wrap it around, just like that. It's not real hard. It's not, there's no right or wrong way to do this. It's just use your imagination, and just, you know, you can use multiple colors of clay. Like, see, there's that piece there. And see, you can do that, you know, you can move it down, or you can place the clay wherever you want. So once you've gotten all that, and last night I actually made a bunch of new ones that I'm going to be trying also, which are these guys here, the fake salmon eggs. So what I'll do with this is fish a lot of trout with these guys. Salmon eggs work good for trout. So what I'll do is I'll put a trout ball here for scent. And these guys will be permanently onto the hook. So when they go for that first one, if they take off with it, they're gonna say, oh man, I left some more behind, let's go get them. So they will go back for the second ones. And if those are a lot tougher to get off, they're gonna try it, you know. As long as the smell's there, some kind of bait, you're good, you know. But there's those. I also made this little guy here. Yet I'm still, I need to bait these guys, And then I kind of make the same one, kind of the opposite colors there. And I did do a fake power egg there on the one hook, see? You could do whatever you want. I mean, like I said, use your imagination. Here's a few of those little white grubs. These ones seem to work the most. The glow in the dark ones, yet I do sell them. I sell them just to like my friends and stuff like that, and I give them away. Sometimes I give some away, and then just like that. But I like giving things, so that's just the way that I am. You can use whatever colors and whatever patterns that you want or that you think are going to work for you the best, or wherever it is that you're fishing. If that's what's working there, then go with it. You know, like I said before, fishing is fishing. You don't know what you're gonna pull out. I mean, heck, I mean, I didn't know I was gonna pull out a big old walleye with this bait, and I did. So you never know what you're gonna catch with whatever it is that you make. And I'll tell you what, I've been fishing a lot. As you can see, I'm just, you know, I'm a fishing nut. I love to fish. I kayak fish. I have an inflatable boat that I take down because I don't have a garage. I can't, you know, have a boat or anything like that. But I wish I could, you know. But for right now, you know, I use only what I need when I go fishing. I try to take the least amount of stuff that you know I can take, because like I said, I don't have a boat, a big boat where I can always leave my stuff. So I have an inflatable boat, so I always have to, you know, inflate, deflate it, you know. But of course in the summer months, then that time I will inflate it, keep it on a trailer, and that's what I do, is I'll trailer it around. But for you guys love to fish, you know, I love it, and I don't know if you guys like it as much as I do. I'm sure there's some of you guys that just love this kind of stuff, you know, but I do, and I'm hoping that you guys stay tuned for some more videos that, you know, I'm going to try to make. And as you see, that some of these things that I make, you know, are just that they're simple, they're tiny, you know. I'm used to making small things, you know, like this box. Some people always wonder what's in the box, you know. Well, this is I'm gonna just show you guys, because this is the kind of things that I, you know, I make. And if you guys are wondering, okay, well, is this what this guy does all day long, is make little fishing hooks? No, I build things. I custom build things for people. I custom make things. If they usually ask me, hey, well, that's pretty cool, I can't believe you made that, you know, or, you know. But this little box here stores most of my Dremel bits. So there it is. Yeah, so I made this little box. No nails, no nothing, just glue. This is just made out of epoxy and wood and some small tools. And of course, you know, this pops out, you know. And there's more accessories in the bottom there. And somebody told me, and I know for myself, that you're always losing this stupid little key. So what I did was magnetized it to the box. Yeah, you're never going to lose it. And you're never going to lose your bits. And if you're sitting there working, this sits on the box. Boom. You're there, you know. If you're working on it, you just give it a toss. It's gonna always land on there. It's not gonna go nowhere. You won't put your stuff away. It's pretty much there. So there it is. To the person who was wondering about the box, there you go. So yeah, there it is. I do make things like that. I make a lot of things, as you've seen on another video that I made, that hook stand. And I made that because I needed something to dry some of my lures that I make, and that seemed like a pretty good idea. That, you know, I was kind of bored also, so I figured, you know what, I'm just gonna make a quick video. But sometimes they're not just quick videos. It's a lot harder than people think to make these videos. So I'm glad that the people that are watching these, they like the videos that are making that I'm making so far. But I just want to say it isn't an easy task, but I do enjoy doing it. I wish I can bring more things that I can build for you guys. You know, I mean, for right now, I mean, I guess I could just show you, like I showed you the crankbait lure. Well, I've been experimenting with other ones, you know, like this one here, and I did make that one, and I actually, this one here, this one goes to prove how impatient I am sometimes. So I didn't have any acrylic to actually use for that piece there to make it drag down. So what I did, I used a Colorado spinner for a spinner rig for walleye fishing, and actually works, and it's got more reflective stuff there. So as it's swimming through there, it actually, you know, reflects a lot of light and it attracts a lot of fish. And I haven't been able to go out and really fish this one where I wanted to, because I know that there, where I want to use this at, there's really big fish, and I can't wait to use this. Now this lure here, I'm just interested, I'm intrigued in it. Since it's getting really cold out right now, I can't really go out and fish much places. So let it get really cold and let things start to freeze over, because I can't wait till fishing season starts. You know, right now everything's just, you know, we're getting all the wind, all the rain, and kids just were been out for Halloween, and yeah, there's just a lot of things going on right now. And I just wanted to say I'm sorry I didn't explain all these things the first time and in the first video. But if you do have any more questions or any comments, feel free to comment below or whatever. You know, you guys know the drill. I'm sure you guys been on YouTube, you guys have been through this a bunch of times. So again, I want to thank my subscribers. I know it's just a few for right now, but you know what? I've been watching the analytics on the YouTube, and it seems that we get a lot of views out there. There has been a lot of views against to those people who are viewing this video. I want to thank you guys also. If you guys think that maybe a friend of yours or anybody that you know may be interested in some of the videos that I make, because they're fishermen and they're into doing their own stuff, you know, I don't just make pan fishing lures, I make repairs to a lot of things. I make repairs to fishing reels. Friends of mine will have a favorite reel that they just absolutely love. They don't want to let it go because it's their lucky reel, and they gotta have it, you know, and they gotta have it for something. And if they need it fixed, then they bring it to me, and I'll, you know, if I can fix it, I'll fix it for them. But if it's just a reel that's just been like 30,000 years old, or, you know, if it's just a can with string on it, then, you know, okay, I'm sorry, you're getting a new can. But like I said, thank you to all who are watching for the first time. If you're wondering why I made this video, look up the first video that I made, and you'll figure out that it's for the pan fishing lures. And again, I want to know also if you guys really like the lures. Or you don't think they're gonna work. Well, let me tell you, I've already used a few of them. They work. I really like that one. That one's pretty cool. It's like an alien or something with three eyes on each side. You know, like I said, you could be creative and whatever you want. That's what you want to do. You want to put a little alien on there, man, make a little alien. I don't care, creative. You want to put a chili pepper, put a miniature chili pepper on the end of the thing. I mean, like I said, if the fish think it's delicious, they're gonna go for it. I've seen fish just go for just about anything. Anything. That little bit of trash falls into the water, bam! They're on it. And it's unexplainable sometimes, but most of the time it is that reaction bite. They're just wondering, ooh, you know, food, hey, what is that? I gotta taste it, whatever. But these things work. So guys, I'll catch you later. Iggy here, and we're out until the next video. God bless you guys. See y'all.